Hi guys, it's Heather here at the Craft Shack, and I have got a new project for you. This is one that I'm going to do for my new apartment. It is going to be a menu that we can hang on the wall, and we'll be able to write what we're going to have each meal and or each day for dinner or whatever, using these incredible chalk markers that I got from Chalkola. So I'll tell you more about that as we go. I just wanted you to see all the supplies that we're going to start with, and then I'm going to put this into fast forward so that of course you don't have to sit here through the painstaking process while I prepare the surface and everything else. But I will do a voiceover to let you know what it is that I'm doing as I go.
Okay, so I'm super excited about this because I've been wanting to try and make something using these palette boards that you can get at your local craft store. And DecoArt had sent me several products, and one of them was this stain, and I could never for the life of me figure out what I was going to use it for. But I love it because it colorizes, it seals, it finishes all in one product. There's not multiple steps to it or anything, and it gives us great color. And the range of colors that it comes in is quite a lot. So I'm using, I think it's called Barn Door is the name of this color, but it's quite awesome. So there are several things that I want to share with you before we get too far into all of this, and that is that I did prepare this wood off camera by lightly sanding it using a sanding block, and that did take care of any rough edges or any sharp slivers that might have been available on the wood. But what it did not do was get rid of all of the grooves of the wood, which I didn't really want it to. I didn't want those grooves to go away. I wanted that rough texture. Otherwise, I would have just used a solid piece of pine instead of these like faux palette pieces. But the bottom line is the surface is incredibly rough, and the challenge today was how am I going to make this something that I can write on with chalk markers. Now, I knew I wanted to use this Americana Decor color stain because I had this awesome stain, but I didn't know what I was going to do with it. And I'm not really much of a finish furniture DIYer. So it was kind of a challenge for me, but it was really simple with this product because it does actually coat, seal, and create a uniform finish over any surface, really, even rough textured surface like this. So quite cool, self-sealing stain, great color, and I just brushed it on. And you're seeing me do it, brush it on and then wipe it off with a cotton rag. And I was sure to make sure I got those edges because they will be seen when it's hung on the wall. But I did speed this up because it's quite a labor intensive project, to be honest with you. It took me close to a week to do because I had to let multiple layers dry, and I really just did not focus on getting it done quickly. I wanted to take my time and really get to know these products. I was also in a new studio and trying to get used to the environment and the lighting, and so you might see some of that change. But the project idea that I had was to create a menu that I could hang on the wall in our kitchen and that my family would see at a glance what we were going to be having this week. So that's what I did. And I think it's possible that I figured it out. All right, so utilizing various widths of masking tape, I'm just giving myself a sharp edge where I can basically stencil on a line. That's the purpose of this. And I knew I wanted to have some space on the left where I would be putting in the days of the week. I wasn't exactly sure what I was going to do with that, if I was going to actually spell them out or what, but based on the stencils that I actually had in my stock, I decided to go with letters, but I don't want to get too far ahead of myself. So using the various widths of masking tape and making them a skinnier line here and there. It actually made it very simple to make a straight line on this menu. And I am going to use Americana paints because I love how the Americana paint is sort of a one coat wonder. That's what I keep calling it. You don't really have to work too hard to put a solid color down. You don't have to make too many coats. In most cases, one coat is good enough, and I really like that. When I'm purchasing paint, I want to make sure that I am spending the least amount of money on the most amount of product, and DecoArt really does a good job of that because when you only have to coat once, you don't have to have too many bottles of paint. So I pulled out a bunch of tools because I was going to experiment, and I do experiment throughout this video on different ways to stencil. And I used a brush in sort of a dark brown color, and I do dry in between, and I left all that in because I really wanted you to see just how labor intensive this project is, but I think in the end it's totally worth it. So I'm using a brush to just sort of swipe it on there. And I'm not sure if you saw when I put the tape down, I was really careful to make sure I burnished all the edges because I wanted to make sure that there was a sharp, crisp edge. So, like I'm showing you here, there are lots of different ways that you can stencil, and this is a DecoArt stencil that I'm using here. It's a beautiful doily stencil. I thought it would add a pretty finish to this, but I noticed right away when I was using the stenciling brush that I had too much paint on my brush and it sort of went underneath the stencil. And so the really cool part about this is you can just wipe it right off. And if you work quickly and it's still wet, it'll come right off. So the tip here for stenciling, whenever you're stenciling anything, is less is more. So you definitely wanna, you can see there, I've zoomed out so you can see that I've put paint on my palette surface there, the table, and just sort of really spread out the paint. So I'm using less paint every time I do this. And it really doesn't even look like I'm adding any color at all to the stencil, but when you lift it up, it's there. Now, I knew I wanted to put down these decorative elements all before I actually sealed the whole piece. Now, this color stain that I used, that red color, which is actually called brick, I think I called it something else earlier, but it's called brick, is the name of the color that I used, and it actually seals itself. So you don't need to do anything to save the wood or save the project. But what I wanted to do with these Chalkola markers, they're a wet white marker, so I wanted a non-porous surface, which the color stain does create that for you, but I really wanted it to be smoother, a lot smoother than the finish was. So I have another product that I'm going to be showing you coming up here that I actually put on. It is an Americana decor item, so it's in that same line of awesome products from DecoArt. And it actually is a light satin varnish. So we'll be talking about that as we get to it. But so basically, what I did here was utilizing the stencils that I had. Several of them were very nice decorative elements, like the doily and a filigree that I'm going to use after I do this. But I saw this, the word family, and I really thought it would be nice to put that at the top of this. It wasn't in the original plan, but you know, sometimes when you see something, you just gotta go with it. So here I'm using a piece of foam, sponge foam type thing. That's what I'm using to do the stenciling on this, and I really found like that was the best out of all the techniques that I used. I think using this the foam allowed, it's actually just a piece of I think it's from the ink blending tools from Ranger, and it's just one of the rectangle sponges. I'm just using it with my finger, but I really felt like I could control how much paint was being put on, and it didn't make a mess at all. It really, really did a great job. And then once it's dry, you're able to attach your next layer and move on. And it really dries quickly because you're using so little paint. So this entire video really shows you several techniques, how to stain wood using amazing Americana Decor color stain, how to decorate it using Americana paints and stencils, and some ideas on different ways to stencil. This is actually a dowel with a sponge on the end of it. That kind of worked too, but there was a lot of, I don't know if I have enough, I don't know if I have too much paint on the end, so that was kind of different. But and I am using gold paint, but I can't remember which. I think it's from the DecoArt media line to put those fancy things on. So now what I do here is I flip it around upside down so that it's basically a mirror of itself from the top. That was the purpose of that. And I did add a little bit of dark to it because I felt like it just sort of disappeared on that wood. So I was sort of mixing gold and black, and it gave it a really cool finish. Okay, so basically at this point, I'm going to let everything dry pretty much overnight because I don't want anything to smear. I have some decorations on it, basically the doily going here and there. And I am going to make sure it's totally dry, but then I am going to add a layer of Americana Decor light satin varnish. And I showed you the bottle there very briefly. And I want you to pay attention to, I am using a very wide brush. It's about a 1 inch, basically it's an acrylic brush. And I painted the entire thing using the light satin varnish. And I'm just showing you here, the entire coat is on. This is one coat, and it kind of has like a milky finish to it at this point. It will dry 100% clear. You will be able to see totally through it as if it's not even there, but it gives a really thick, luscious finish. And it's a satin finish, so it doesn't have that harsh glare that you're seeing at the moment because it's wet. I'm showing you here the bottle, not a very good shot, I know, but I'm showing you here the bottle of it. So I wanted you to see that it is about 4 ounces, and there's the size of that brush. And here's the tip I have for you. Make long side-to-side strokes, not those tiny little jagged strokes. Long side-to-side. Okay, so here we are. It is finally dry, and although it was a pretty good coat that was put on there, it still is pretty rough. I don't know if you'll be able to hear this or not. It still has some rough edges or graininess to it, which it's wood, and I expected that it would for quite some time. Didn't expect it to become smooth in the first coat. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to put on probably two more coats of this light satin varnish, and I think at the end of that it might be good enough to write on it with the chalk markers, but I still have one more thing I want to do before we get to that stage. All right, so we've put on a couple of coats of that light satin varnish by now. I did let them dry at least 24 hours in between, because I wanted to make sure it was totally dry and that I wasn't going to mess up the finish. What I do like is that it is quite satin. But before I get into that, I did want to let you know I took a ruler and using a water-soluble pencil, I drew a white line that would act as my center. Now, I went ahead and started stenciling and made a mistake. Too much paint. So I'm going back to that, really my favorite way to stencil, which was that foam pad. And I'm mixing several light colors, trying to get something that will stand up off of that board. I had actually changed my mind. I was originally going to do the first three letters of each day of the week, and I changed my mind to just do the singular letter. I think that made it simpler, and plus I was able to use the one stencil that I did have that had all those letters on it. Except, excuse me, except I did have to get a little creative with the W, but you'll see. So the key for me was to put on really light lettering or light layers and then lift it off and then make sure it was dry before I moved on to taping it to the next section. But overall, this was a pretty simple piece. So what was really cool about doing all of this was that I was able to do a straight line of the letters, and I felt like the simplified, I think the simplified part of this was that it was just the first letter of each day of the week. And you know, in different places in the world, you start your week with Sunday or you start your week with Monday. I'm a Sunday starter, so I was able to what do you call that? Make it mine. I don't know. So I did have to clean up a few edges because on some of those slats, there's a lot more texture to the wood than there was on some of the others. So it was really important. The nothing you could do really. The stencil was going to be off the edges, and it was going to get underneath the stencil no matter what you did. So just working quickly with acrylic paint, you can actually clean it up quite well. And if you have alcohol wipes, like all of my baby wipes are alcohol free, so I don't actually have any alcohol wipes. But if you have specifically alcohol wipes, then you can actually remove the acrylic paint at this stage. So here's where I got creative. I took the M that you saw me use to do Monday and turned it upside down. I'm using the center part for the center of the W. Just creative with the tape makes it much easier to do. Lining up the mark there and sort of putting the line at an angle, and all of a sudden I have a W. So this is kind of a lesson in how to stretch your stencils as well. So don't ever feel like you're locked into one thing and one thing only. That's one thing we do here at the Craft Shack is break those boundaries. So after I had gotten all of the letters put on, I'll finish up here with the F for Friday. After I got all the letters on, I really felt like it was just too flat. So I decided to sort of shadow the letters, and I did that with using the artist pit brushes. Yeah, they have India ink within them, so they actually, it's permanent once it's dry, but you do have a little bit of leeway where you can smudge it with your fingers. So after I'd cleaned up all the edges with the baby wipe that I'm doing there and made sure everything was just so, and of course dried it really well, I went ahead and got my artist pit pens and decided to shadow those letters. And I'm using black and I believe white. I end up using a white as well. So this actually, I felt like it just solidified the whole piece for me because they really do seem like they are letters on a signboard. And I'm really happy with this piece overall. I think that it did exactly what I wanted it to do. It works great with the Chalkola markers. I'll be showing you at the very end here how I actually use it. We did hang it using a wire hanging method that you would use for any painting, and just purchased the eye hooks and the wire at a hardware store. And my trusty Mr. Crafter went ahead and installed that for me so it would hang on the wall. And it's actually quite functional and it looks great too. So I hope that you have really enjoyed this demonstration of how to use some DecoArt products and how they marry really well with the Chalkola wet white markers. These These markers are amazing, and they come in some pretty cool colors. And the sets of them are really awesome as well. And Chalkola has been gracious enough to offer anyone watching this video a coupon. So you'll want to make sure you head over to the blog post that is linked up in the corner of this video, or it's linked down in the description as well. And head to the blog post where you can get the code to purchase Chalkola markers for yourself and save a little bit when you do. So this particular technique of being able to write with the marker and then sort of fludge it with your finger a little bit, or smudge it, however you want to say, really adds a great shadow. And then, of course, if you don't like what you did, you can just wipe it right off with the marker, or I'm sorry, with the baby wipe, as long as it's wet. And then once it's dry, it's permanent and it's not smudging. And I did really feel like after I had done this, I needed one more coat of that Americana Decor light satin varnish. So I do get that out, and I'll show you really quickly the bottle. So pay attention here. You'll see the jar is a 4 ounce jar. I pretty much used all but 1 ounce to do this entire piece, and I want you to take a look at that when I show it on screen. I did grab the white marker because I felt like it needed a little bit of highlight after I'd added all that black. So once that's totally dry, I then go in with the final stage of light satin varnish, and I ended up using, like I said, I think it was a total of 4 coats. I believe there were 3 coats in between, and then now this final coat that goes on top, and it works like a dream, and I'll just go ahead and show you in the next portion of the video. So thanks for watching. Okay, so this is the menu board completed, and the way that I'm using it is I put the days of the week or the dates of the days of the week next to it, and then I write down what each meal is that we're going to be having. Using these Chalkola markers is really cool because they wipe right off. So if I make a mistake, like what we might have here, and then I remember, oh, on the 16th, we're not going to have chicken. Just get the paper towel wet and it wipes right off. And so then I can say, we're actually going to go to see the comedian. That means we're eating out.